Huh. It doesn't taste like sweat. Y'all like pizza? Hey guys, what's up? It's me, ya boy. Today I'm really shiny. By the way, I'm using my lamp on my desk and it's very shiny, but anyways, more importantly, today I really want to talk about a couple of things. It's my second week here in Japan because of the COVID pandemic 2020. I have to stay indoors. I have to stay at a hotel for 2 weeks. This is my first week already. I still have one more week to go before I can travel to Fukuoka. But here I am, still in Tokyo. And today, I want to talk about three things that I really liked so far. I want to talk about pizza, I want to talk about beer, and I want to talk about sweat. Yeah, that's really weird. Pocari Sweat. I want to talk about Pocari Sweat. And a little something else that I really liked. Anyways, yeah. So let's get started. I want to go right on and start talking about pizza. This is not sponsored, but I wish. Maybe one day. Pizza Hut. Do you guys like Pizza Hut? I actually really like Pizza Hut. Not really. I really, when I was a kid, I used to really love Pizza Hut. I would always get the meat lovers. Yeah, it was my favorite thing ever. Not sponsored, by the way. But I actually don't like, for some, after some years, I don't know, something happened to Pizza Hut and their pizza quality just went down. And then Domino's started making really good pizzas. And yeah, basically, Domino's is pretty good. But I occasionally like ordering Pizza Hut just, you know, because of nostalgia. I really like the pizza, the hot cheese crust. Anyways, I couldn't find that in Japan. Maybe I'm just not literate enough to find it on the menu. But I ordered Uber Eats and I tried this wonderful pizza. Well, this pizza, it costed me $33. Actually, that's not true. That's not true. It's probably like $32 or $21. But yeah, that was a pretty expensive pizza. The pizza was kind of small, actually. I'm not sure why. Maybe it's like 10 inches, while I guess the medium-sized pizza in the United States is maybe 12 inches. I mean, maybe it's not a huge difference, but considering the price, it's very solid difference. Now, usually, I don't really order a lot in the pizza. I don't like add things, but this time I wanted to add a couple of things. I think onions. I added onions, extra cheese, and something else that I'm forgetting. But anyways, I ordered something else, and yeah, it was like a sausage. It was pretty good though. It was really good. It was like Italian sausage, some other kind of sausage, pepperoni, and yeah, that's it. And crispy. It was really thin. So that was pretty good. It was actually a really tasty pizza. But yeah, it was kind of, it was a surprisingly a little smaller than I would have, you know, expected. And it was really expensive, that's for sure. But it was good nonetheless, you know. There's all kinds of stories I can share about eating pizza. So I live in Chicago sometime, and I really love to order the Jet's pizza. It's like rectangle. It's really good though. That was not even a rectangle. It's rectangle. Was that better? I don't think that was better. Rectangle. Yeah, that's better. So it was a really good pizza, Jet's pizza. It's like really fatty and really just huge, and it's really nice. I loved it. It's got like a ton of sauce. I ordered it with no, it comes with different types of crusts that you can get, garlic, sesame seeds, and parmesan, and some other stuff. I don't remember, but I usually ordered the sesame seeds crust. It's really yummy. And I would order the Jet's Deluxe, maybe, which is like peppers, Italian sausage, onion, and some other stuff. Green bell peppers, I think. It was really great, anyways. and extra cheese probably. Yeah, I used to order that all the time. And it wasn't that expensive, maybe like $25, maybe? It was a pretty big pizza. It was pretty solid. Because it's a rectangle, it's kind of harder to measure, but it was more. It was definitely more than this pizza right here. It's probably a large, like a normal large size in America. Anyways, yeah, pizza, it's a very big deal for me. I could talk about for hours about pizza, but maybe another time. I just wanted to say about Japanese pizza, and I haven't tried older kind of pizzas. Maybe I will during my stay. I for sure will try a lot of pizzas during my stay, but yeah, I'll keep you guys posted on that. So they're ripped, but it's beer. Again, not sponsored, but I wish. Yeah, I really like Sapporo. It's not the first time I tried Sapporo. I've actually tried it before a couple of times. I've also tried Asahi. Maybe this is gonna be controversial to my like 5 viewers, but I really like Sapporo, probably a little bit more than Asahi. I'll have to do a lot of testing to be sure, so I'll get back to you guys on that. But yeah, this 6-pack was about $6, I want to say. It's probably about, you know, a good price. It's about the same price you'd find a 6-pack in America. So yeah, it was good. I liked it. Funny little story, I hurt my back a couple of days ago, so I did not have any ice. I sprained my lower back. I didn't have any ice, so I just improvised and put some nice cold beer on on my back, and it helped a lot. Now I'm good, I'm all better, so yeah, thank you, Sapporo. It's not the first time you've saved my life, beer. Now, the next thing I want to talk about to you about, guys, is Pocari Sweat. I've seen it a lot on videos, I've seen it a lot everywhere. It's the first time I tried it, and it's pretty good. For those of you that don't know what Pocari Sweat is, it's, as it says, it's an ion supply drink. It provides you with ions. Pocari Sweat is a healthy beverage that smoothly supplies the lost water and electrolytes during perspiration. With the appropriate density in electrolytes close to that of human body fluid, it can be easily absorbed into the body, as Sweat says. Yeah, and a bunch of stuff on the back, which I don't remember. Oh, but it does give you the contents of the actual ingredient. Well, not ingredients, but, well, yeah, part of the ingredients, the actual minerals in it. It's what, sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and this other stuff. I don't know what it is, but anyways, yeah, pretty good, I guess. Actually, the taste was a little weird. I think in America a lot of sports drinks are, by the way, this is supposed to be a sports drink. In America a lot of sports drinks are supposed to be, you know, sweet, like really sweet, and that's what I don't like. They're really, really too sweet, and they have this like syrupy kind of feeling to it as well. So I'm not a big fan of sports drinks in America. But this was not bad. This was really different. As I tried to make it sound good, it was different. It was actually very different from the usual. It's a little, like, it has a little bit of saltiness at the end, or not really at the end, like very upfront, it's like a little bit salty and sweet. So it's a little strange, but I guess it makes sense if it's supposed to, you know, hit you with those electrolytes. You're supposed to, you are supposed to drink some sodium after a workout. You're not supposed to, but it helps. It's good to replenish electrolytes. But yeah, that was a very strange kind of flavor. I'm not used to it. It's good. I liked it, actually, a lot more than the just pure sweetness of energy drinks in America. But hey, it's not for everyone, probably. If you ever see it, give it a try and tell me what you think. I think it's not bad. Yeah. Next thing that I want to talk to you guys about, and this is like a bonus round because I run out of ideas, and I thought that ending the video like that was going to be kind of lame. But anyways, again, not sponsored, but I really wish I was sponsored by this one. But I did try Famichiki. Oh yeah, it's torn in two, by the way, so don't think I'm just... Famichiki, it's so good. It's the best thing I've ever tried in my life. I say that, but no, it's really good, though. Famichiki. It says, taste of soft, juicy chicken. The boneless type. just to be sure it's the boneless type. Yeah, the boneless chicken. Yeah, it's really good though. It's really amazing. I actually really like the taste. It is actually kind of juicy, but it's not actually juicy. Like, if you really try it and try to think about what you're tasting, it's not like wet chicken kind of juicy. Like when you cook the chicken like right perfectly, and it's still like moist inside. I know it's a weird word for some, but it's like moist and it's still like watery, kind of like the good kind of watery. It's still juicy. It's not like that. It's actually the chicken part is actually pretty dry, but it could. From what I could taste and see, it's like a chicken, like in the middle there's chicken, and then there's like a glossy, juicy layer of what I think maybe is like gelatin or something, and then the actual crispy breading, I guess, which is pretty good, and it's got a lot of pepper. I tried the normal flavor. Apparently there's like a spicy flavor, which I really want to try, but yeah, anyways. It's really good. If you guys are ever around here, try it. I love it. I'm already addicted. I'm this close of just going outside and getting one every day. It's that good, yeah. But anyways, famichiki, it's got a lot of peppery flavor. It's salty, juicy. Well, not juicy, but like, yeah, glossy. Not glossy. What word is glossy? It's juicy. It's not juicy, it's like gelatinous. It's gelatinous, that's the word. So, yeah, juicy, gelatinous, almost the same thing. Anyways, on the package, you're supposed to rip it off and eat it like this. But yeah, I kind of didn't, I did not a great job ripping it apart. Anyways, there is behind it, there's a cute, I don't know what this code. Where this goat leads, but it's a cute bear. This is how you're supposed to rip it, and you can just okay on the microwave. God, this is the okay microwave sign, I guess, to warm it up, to heat it up again, I guess. But yeah, anyways, I just wanted to share the famichiki with you guys. It's really good. Try it. You won't regret it. So that's it for today. Very short video, I think, but I don't really know what to talk about. I'm trapped in here, so there's not, like, I can't really go outside and, like, explore Tokyo and do anything because, you know, the pandemic, I have to stay inside. So I'm, you know, just enjoying my life here for now. I'm 1 week away from traveling to Fukuoka. I'm just going to enjoy my time here. In my room, I mean. So yeah, maybe next video I'll finally be in my room in Fukuoka. I can show you guys around and we can get this started. I don't know. We'll see what happens. I'll see you guys in the next video. That's it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Yeah. Let me know in the comments how to finish a video. I don't know how to finish a video. See you guys later. I'm not gonna do the blogger thing where you just zoom, like, black out the camera. That's kind of lame. That's kind of, sorry guys.